एमरफो सॉलिड एंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन क्रिस्टलाइन एंड एमरफो सॉलिड। सो यू नो अबाउट इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड एज वेल एज द टाइप ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड। सो हियर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट एमरफस सॉलिड। यू स्टूडेंट्स यू नो द एमरफस सॉलिड इज ऑल्सो नॉन एज स्यूडो सॉलिड और सुपर कूल्ड लिक्विड। सो वॉट डू मीन बाई स्यूडो सॉलिड? स्यूडो सॉलिड आर दो सॉलिड विच हैव टेंडेंसी टू लाइक एज लिक्विड। इट मीन्स दे हैव टेंडेंसी टू फ्लो वेरी स्लोली, नॉट इन कंपेरिजन टू लिक्विड, बट दे हैव टेंडेंसी टू फ्लो। सो इट इज नोन एज स्यूडो सॉलिड और सुपर कूल्ड लिक्विड। सो फर्स्ट वन इज स्यूडो सॉलिड। स्यूडो सॉलिड और सुपर कूल्ड सॉलिड। ओके, सो दो सॉलिड विच हैव टेंडेंसी टू फ्लो वेरी स्लोली is called pseudo solid. They resembles in many respect liquid. So amorphous solid are considered to be pseudo solid, like as example is glass. Okay students, now we have discussed the difference between crystalline solid as well as amorphous solid. So here we will discuss difference between crystalline solid and amorphous solids. It's very important, no doubt one or two more questions are in the difference, in the basis of difference asked in many times. So you have to learn very well and write it very quickly. So first of all, we have two parts, like is crystalline solid and the other one side is amorphous solid. Okay students, first difference in both the type of solid. First, if I told about arrangement of the type of solid, so you know the regular or orderly arrangement of the constituent particles in crystalline solid, so they have a long range of order, while in the case of amorphous solid they are a regular arrangement for short time, so they act as a irregular. So the difference is regular, or we can say order in arrangement of constituent particles. C for constituent, P for particle, constituent particles for a long range order. For long range, yani ki it means if we move in long range of order, the regular arrangement of particles will take place, like as A B A B A B type, A B A B A B A B type. Okay, on the basis of example. While in the case of amorphous solid, no doubt regular arrangement will be obtained for short order, not for long order. So regular arrangement of constituent particles for short range order, like as A B A B V A B V. No doubt it will order follow A V and A V. Further, it will not follow. So, regular arrangement of order for short range. The first difference between amorphous solid and crystalline solid. Okay, here we will discuss next nature. If you ask anyone what is the nature of crystalline solid and amorphous solid, so you have to told crystalline solid by nature is true solid. It acts as a true solid, while they act as a pseudo solid. Pseudo-solid or super-cooled liquid. Super-cooled liquid. Third one is, it's melt at a sharp. Melt at a sharp and characteristic temperature. Temperature means it melt at a fixed temperature, while in the case of amorphous solid, gradually soften over a range of temperature. Means first of all they have to soft, and after that they become melt, so they can easily molded. On the basis of molding, plastic can be molded easily. If you melt the plastic, first of all plastic will be normally molded on the heating of temperature. So we have discussed the curve of melting curve of these type of solid. So first of all we have discussed heating curve of crystalline solid. So if we take temperature on this side on the y-axis, and time will be taken on the x-axis. So if point A have any solid, you know, if you have increased the temperature, then it start will be melted at a melting point, like as these are the melting point. But here A to B, it we have as a like as a solid. But if you increase the temperature point V to C, here sharp melting point means V to C is studied solid plus liquid, because solid change into liquid, totally solid change into liquid V to C. And further C to D totally is liquid. Similarly, in the case of amorphous solid, you know, it is a temperature of range, it's often range of temperature. So the heating curve of amorphous solid, here we take temperature and time. So no sharp point is taken in the type of amorphous solid. Here V to C is a sharp melting point. Like as if this point A is melting point and totally solid is melt at 120 degree Celsius, means it point A is have 20 degree Celsius, so it's total melt at 120 degree Celsius. So it's a basic difference between heating curve of both the type of solids. Clear for everyone? Next, we will discuss cooling curve of these type of solids. So, dear students, we have discussed cooling curve. Here we take crystalline solid, and in another side is amorphous solid. So we have discussed cooling curve at just reverse of the heating curve. Here we take temperature and time. So first of all, on the basis of degree, the temperature, when high temperature, the substance solid act as a liquid. When it comes to melting point, then it is sharp melting point. Here we liquid plus solid, and after that degrees the temperature, totally will be solid. So here solid plus liquid, and in this is totally liquid. Point A, B, C and D. While in the case of amorphous solid, no sharp melting point, so it will decreases totally. When the temperature is decreases, it cool easily. So basic difference between the temperatures of crystalline solid as well as amorphous solid. Now students, next property will be discussed in next lecture.